Hello everyone, today I am Rishabh Bhardwaj, assistant professor from the mechanical department taking the lecture of applied thermodynamics. Today in this lecture we will study about the refrigeration and the vapor compression refrigeration system, or we can say the cycle. For the first we will discuss what is refrigeration. The term refrigeration may be defined as the process of removing heat from the substance under the controlled conditions. Controlled conditions means that every factors are being under controlled, and it also includes the process of reducing heat and maintaining the temperature of the body below the general temperature of its surroundings. In the vapor compression system, we have four components, and the four components are the evaporator, compressor, condenser, and the expansion valve, by which the hot gases entered in the system, by which we are able to compress that, and then the condenser will reduce the heat of the system, and expansion valve allow them to work or move outward. The condenser and the liquid receiver phase are the high pressure side, and the evaporator comes under the low pressure side. In between the compressor and the expansion valve are the in between them. Highly compressed fluid tends to get colder when they allow to expand. If the pressure is high enough, then the compressed air is hotter than the source of cooling, and the expanded gas cooler than the desired cold temperature. There are two advantages of vapor compression refrigeration: that the lot of heat can be removed from this type of cycle, and lots of thermal energy will convert into the liquid to vapor state, and heat transfer rate remains the same for the entire process, and the temperature of working fluid much lower than what is being cooled. This is a basic cycle of refrigeration. You can see that from the first evaporation or the boiling or evaporator help to heat up the fluid, and that will transfer to the compressor, by which it will convert into the high pressure and send it to the condenser. By the help of condenser, we are able to remove the heat of the fluid and allow them to pass through the expansion valve. It will allow to again to recirculate through the evaporator. The time when we use the evaporator will take in the heat of the surroundings and make the surroundings cooler as compared to the earlier one. The evaporator has a low pressure liquid refrigerant in evaporator that absorb heat and the changes into the gas, and the low pressure liquid which absorb the gas are the gases which are available at the and our environment. Then we have a evaporator. The evaporator coils are located in the compartment to be cooled. लोअर प्रेशर लिक्विड रेफ्रिजरेंट आफ्टर पासिंग थ्रू द एक्सपेंशन वाल्व इट विल एक्सपेंड. इट विल बी टेकन इन हीट फ्रॉम द सराउंडिंग्स एंड इट इवेपोरेट्स. द गैस इज देन सग्ड बाय द कंप्रेसर एंड द अमाउंट ऑफ हीट एडेड टू द लिक्विड टू मेक इट सैचुरेटेड एंड चेंज स्टेट इट्स कॉल्ड सुपर हीटेड स्टेट. एज यू कैन सी इन दिस डायग्राम दैट हीट इज टेकन एट द इनिशियल एंड द बॉइलिंग स्टार्ट्स बाय विच थ्रू द हेल्प ऑफ ट्यूब्स इट विल गो डाउनवर्ड वेयर द बॉइलिंग फिनिशेज एंड फर्दर सुपर हीटेड हीट विल बी गेन्ड एंड इट विल सेंड टू द नेक्स्ट सेंड फॉर द नेक्स्ट प्रोसेस. देन वी हैव अ सुपर हीटेड वेपर. द सुपर हीटेड वेपर आर एंटर्ड टू द कंप्रेसर वेयर इट्स प्रेशर इज रेज्ड. द लो प्रेशर सुपर हीटेड स्टीम विल कन्वर्टेड इंटू हाई प्रेशर स्टीम. द फंक्शन ऑफ द कंप्रेसर इज दैट द इट इज द हार्ट ऑफ द सिस्टम. द कंप्रेसर डज जस्ट वट इट्स नेम इज. इट कंप्रेसिज द लो प्रेशर रेफ्रिजरेंट वेपर फ्रॉम द इवेपोरेटर एंड कंप्रेसिज इट इंटू अ हाई प्रेशर. द इनलेट ऑफ द कंप्रेसर इट्स कॉल्ड सक्शन लाइन एंड इट ब्रिंग्स द लो प्रेशर वेपर इंटू द कंप्रेसर. आफ्टर द कंप्रेसर कंप्राइजेज द रेफ्रिजरेंट इंटू हाई प्रेशर वेपर इट रिमूव इट टू द आउटलेट कॉल्ड डिस्चार्ज लाइन एंड द डिस्चार्ज लाइन अलाउ इट टू पास थ्रू द कंडेंसर. देन द हाई प्रेशर सुपर हीटेड गैस इज कूल्ड इन सेवरल स्टेजेस इन द कंडेंसर. द मेन फंक्शन ऑफ द कंडेंसर इज टू टेकन द डिस्चार्ज दैट लीव्स फ्रॉम द कंप्रेसर एंड रन्स टू द इनलेट ऑफ द कंडेंसर. Because of the compressed, the refrigerant was compressed, it is hot and high pressure. The hot vapor enters the condenser and starts to follow through the tubes. Since the air is cooled or cooler than the refrigerant, heat jumps from the tubing to the air cooler. As the heat is removed from the refrigerant, it reaches to its saturated temperature and starts to boil, by which it will change its states into a high pressure liquid. The high pressure liquid leaves the condenser through the liquid line and travels to the metering device. Sometimes the running through a filter dryer first and remove any dust and the foreign particles from the system. Then we have a thermal expansion valve, or generally known as the expansion valve. This is a inlet gating for the process by which we are able to stop the heat or allow them to pass on. The expansion valve acting as a regulating valve which limits the amount of refrigerant to flow through. Resulting of it, it is reduced or it allow the reduction of pressure of the liquid and the expansion. Next in this category we have the refrigerant. Initially we have to study what is refrigerant and what are the categories of the refrigerant. For the first we have different type of different types of refrigerant that are used for the cooling purpose. That was the first
is that the CFCs, generally we use the CFCs, and for the betterment and the complex chlorofluorocarbons, we have introduced the name and put it as a R11, R12, R21, R22, R50, 5025, 134A, R72, and much more, and R32. Let's discuss what is refrigerant and what composition of the chemicals and forms this refrigerant. Refrigerant is a fluid used for heat transfer in a refrigerating system that absorbs heat during the evaporation from the region of low temperature and pressure, and it releases heat during condensation at a region of higher temperature and pressure. If we classify the refrigerant, we have the two categories for the refrigerant, that is primary refrigerant and the secondary refrigerant. The primary refrigerant are which cool the substance or space directly by absorbing the latent heat, or in the secondary refrigerant, the coolant is used as a cooling medium which absorb heat from the refrigerated space and transfer to primary refrigerant in evaporator. Secondary refrigerant are also called or known as the under name, that is brine or antifreezes. In the primary, if you're talking about the primary refrigerant, it absorbs heat during the evaporation, or the evaporation will be done by the evaporator and releases heat energy during the condensation in condenser. It's also known as the direct expansion system. For the example, for the primary refrigerant, that are ammonia, freons, CO2, etc. These fluids provide refrigeration by undergoing a phase change process in the evaporator. We have the classification of primary refrigerants, that are halocarbon refrigerant, azeotrope refrigerant, inorganic refrigerant, and hydrocarbon refrigerant. Let's start with the halocarbon refrigerant. The halocarbon refrigerant are all synthetically produced and were developed as the freons family of refrigerant.
The fluorocarbons of methane and ethane series, they contain one or more of these halogens, that are chlorine, bromine, and fluorine. They non-toxic and non-flammable and non-explosive, non-corrosive, non-irritant to the human body and eyes also. They are odorless and the colorless in nature and will not be react with food product stored in the refrigerated space. And simultaneously, it will not react with the lubricating oil. It has excellent thermodynamic property, and the disadvantage is that it will damage the ozone layer. For the such halogens refrigerant, the examples are R11, R12, R13, R114 and 115. For HCFC, that is R22 and R123, and R134A and 404A and 407C and 410A. These are the halogens. Then freon. The freons are the difluoromethane. They are mostly used in the domestic and the commercial refrigerant. They are generally used for the ice cream cabinets and display cabinets and the deep freezer. It is widely used for the colorless gas with mild odor. they are heavier than the air and does not dissolve with water. The moisture content should not exceed to the 0.0025% by the weight. The refrigerating effect per unit volume of ammonia is about 1.5 times that of freons. It does not react with the ferrous metal, aluminium and phosphorus bronze. It attacks to the copper, copper alloys, zinc and bronze and dissolve in water and does not react with lubricating oil in the presence of moisture but oxidizes them in the presence of water vapor. The Freon's group refrigerant have an application and having the ODP values. The refrigerant that is R11 that used for the air conditioning system ranging from 200 to 2000 ton in the capacity, and it is used where low freezing point and non-corrosive property are important. Then we have a R12. It is used for most of the application and air conditioning plants, refrigerator, freezer, ice cream cabinet, water cooler, water air condenser, automobile air conditioners are generally used this R12 gas. R13 gas are used for low temperature up to the minus 90 degrees Celsius in cascade system. R113 is a small to medium air conditioning system and industrial purpose. R114 that are blend of R22 and R115 blend R502. In the household refrigerators and in large industries, cooling and the frozen food ice cream display cases and the warehouse and food freezing plants are used these types of these gases, and excellent general low temperature of refrigerant R had been found. Next we have inorganic refrigerant. The inorganic refrigerant were exclusively used before the introduction of halocarbons. These refrigerant are still in use due to their inherent thermodynamic and physical property. These properties are carbon dioxide, water, ammonia, air and sulfur dioxide. First we will discuss ammonia, that is NH3, and the name has been suggested that R717. It is used for the commercial purposes and mainly in cold store and ice cream plant. The boiling temperature of NH3 at atmospheric pressure is minus 33 degrees Celsius and the melting point from solid is minus 78 degrees Celsius. The low boiling point make it possible to have refrigeration considerably below the 0 degree without using the pressure below atmospheric in the evaporator. The latent heat of the vaporization is about minus 15 degrees Celsius is 1315 Kelvin per kg. It is a odorless gas with a sharp pungent smell. It has good thermodynamic property and neutral to all metal, highly soluble in oil and volatile and non-toxic but in higher cone. Then we have a sulfur dioxide. The sulfur dioxide are also used for the sulfur dioxide is previously used in household refrigerators. They are toxic and non-explosive and non-flammable and non-corrosive in nature. But it irritant to the human body and do not mix with the oil. It has some pungent smell and low latent heat value. next we have the azeotrope refrigerant. This group of refrigerant consists of mixture of different refrigerant which do not separate under pressure and temperature and have fixed thermodynamic property. A stable mixture of two or several refrigerant whose vapor and liquid phase retain identical composition over a wide range of temperature. The azeotropic mixture are designed by 500 series that are 73.8% of R12 and 26.2% of R152. In the combination of R02, the percentage of R22 is 8.8% and the percentage of R115, that is 51.2. For the gas R503, in this the R23 percentage of 40.1% and 59.9% of R13 are present in this combination. Then we have zeotropic. Zeotropic refrigerant. A zeotropic tropic mixture is one whose composition in liquid are different to that in different phase. Zeotropic refrigerant therefore do not boil at constant temperature. Unlike the zeotropic refrigerant are designed by the 400 series. The example are 404A, R407C and many more. Next we have the hydrocarbons. Most of the hydrocarbon refrigerant are successfully used in industrial and the commercial installation. They possess satisfactory and the thermodynamic property but are highly inflammable and explosive. They are growing use in very small commercial system like air conditioning system. The such examples are R170, R290, R600 and R600A. They are the blended of the above gases. Now we have the secondary refrigerant. The secondary refrigerant are brine which is used as intermediate fluid between evaporator and the substance or space to be cooled. They cooled the substance and the space by absorbing their sensible heat and also called as indirect expansion system. For the example, we have the brine solution made up of calcium chloride or sodium chloride. The water cannot be used as a secondary refrigerant because at 0 degrees Celsius itself it will become ice and the circulation is not possible. In the brine solution, calcium chloride is much preferred as it is very high cost and substance that takes away from the heat from the medium to be cooled and give it to the boiling refrigerant are called the secondary refrigerant. They do not change their physical condition and any conditions. They are cheap and harmless, chemical neutral to the metal and packing material. They should have a low freezing point and a large heat capacity. The choice of the brine depends upon the temperature to which a material is to be cooled and industrial process in which it to be used. The calcium chloride brine has eutectic temperature of minus 55 degrees Celsius at salt concentration of 30% of biomass. And the sodium chloride brine has a eutectic temperature of minus 21.1 degrees Celsius at the salt concentration of 23% of biomass. The sodium chloride is used when it desired to have direct contact between the brine and the product. The freezing point of the brine depends on its concentration. That the cheapest secondary refrigerant are water and air, but their applications are limited and the water has a highly
freezing point up to 0 degree Celsius and air has very low heating capacity. Let's discuss about the designation of the refrigerants. Since a large number of refrigerants have developed over the year for the wide variety of for the application, the number of system has been adopted to designate various refrigerant from the number one. Can get one some useful information about the type of refrigerant. Now its chemical composition, the molecular weight and etc. All the refrigerant are designated by the R followed by the unique number. Next we have fully saturated halogenated compounds. These refrigerants are the derivative of the alkane group such as the methane, ethane and etc. These refrigerants are designated by the terms R and by the followed by the XYZ, some numerical values, where X plus 1 indicates the number of the carbon present in that and Y minus 1 indicates that the halogen atoms and Z indicates the fluorine atoms. The balance indicates the number of chlorine atoms and only two digits indicates the value of the X is 0. For example, if we have the R22, then X is 0, that number of carbon present is 0 plus 1, that will be 1. And Y is equal to the 2, that is the number of hydrogen atom, that is 2 minus 1 is 1. And Z is the number of fluorines is 2. The balance is 4 and H plus F is equal to 4 minus 1 minus 2 is equal to 1. So the number of chlorine atom is 1. The chemical formula for R22 is CHClF2. Then fully saturated halogenated compound. Similarly, it has been shown that the chemical formula that R12 is CCl2F2. And from the derivatives on the ethane, we have R134, that is C2H2F4. In the organic refrigerant, these are designated by the number 7 followed by the molecular weight of the refrigerant. Example, the ammonia molecular weight is 17 and the designation is R717. For the carbon dioxide, molecular weight is 44 and the designation is R744. For the water, the molecular weight is 18 and the designation is 718. The physical characteristic of the refrigerant are that boiling and the condensing temperature of the and the pressures are to be maintained at a controllable rate. The freezing temperature should be low and the critical temperature should be high and the discharge temperature would be moderate. Latent heat of vaporization can be accumulated and specific heat should be there and density and the viscosity plays a vital role in this equation. Next we have the thermodynamic property of the refrigerant. The freezing temperature, it should have a low freezing temperature since the freezing temperature of the refrigerant is below minus 35 degrees Celsius. And the critical temperature should be above the maximum condensing temperature. If we discuss about the discharge temperature, the high discharge temperature from the compressor should be avoided and it causes some refrigerant breakdowns as well as the poor lubrication effectiveness. As you can see by the table that the refrigerants have a different freezing temperature by which we can choose up to which or which refrigerant we have to use for our the desired purpose. The evaporator and the condenser pressure, that is the latent heat of the vaporization, the latent the heat is converted to the refrigerant from the liquid state to the vapor. and it should be the higher value. The density of the refrigerant should be low, vapor density, and the refrigerant, these type of refrigerants are preferred. If you're talking about the viscosity, the low viscosity of the liquid refrigerant is desired to reduce the pressure drop in the line. For the chemical properties, we have it should be non-flammable, should be non-explosive, should be not toxic, and should not be reacted with lubricating oil, not reacted, not reaction with the moisture, and should not have the contaminant of the food material kept there inside the refrigerating system. The environmental effect of the refrigerant, the first is the global warming. The refrigerant directly contributing to the global warming that releases to the atmosphere. Indirect contribution based on the energy consumption of among the compressor, carbon dioxide produced by the power station. For this, we are coming to the end, and thank you for watching this video, and stay tuned for the next.